Good morning. It's for me a pleasure to be here with you, sharing my ideas about how to move from a lack of community health project to a model inspired on the value-based orientation and the triple aim initiative. The Galician Health Service is the public body responsible for deploying public and community health policies and offering health services to the citizens of Galicia within the framework of a Spanish health system of national scope, universal coverage, and financed through the general budget. The General Health Law of 1986 gave coverage to the reform of primary care that was implemented from the decade of the 80s and 90s following the guidelines of the Alma-Ata Declaration of 1978. As a result of all this, the primary healthcare in Spain has been planned with population criteria and with administrative circuits that gave it the gatekeeper function, a key issue in the management of the entire health system. However, this function is clearly insufficient today, due to the desires of primary care system that wants to become the backbone of the healthcare system. What are we talking about when we talk about value? In 2006, Michael Porter and Elizabeth Teisberg published Redefining Healthcare, Creating Value-Based Competition on Results, where they said that payers and providers, including doctors and nurses, are very concerned in demonstrating that they work a lot and very little or nothing in assessing what their work contributes to the health of people and communities. Michael Porter is famous in the business world for his work on competitiveness based on the value of products and services. He has introduced this concept in the provision of health services, all summarized in a phrase. Health systems should seek to obtain the maximum possible value for the health of people for every dollar they spend. But to define the value in healthcare, the patient must be introduced into the equation. So, in Porterian terms, the value is the perception that people have about clinical effectiveness in relation to cost of the clinical activities. This is the great definition that we use even in management topics. Yesterday I was in Braga working only in this concept, the perception that people have about clinical effectiveness. And what is value-based healthcare? When we work this concept, according to New England Journal of Medicine Catalyst, value-based healthcare is a healthcare delivery model in which providers, including hospitals and physicians, are paid based on patients' health outcomes. Under value-based healthcare, providers are rewarded for helping patients improve their health, reduce the effects and incidence of chronic diseases, and live healthier lives in an evidence-based way. Can we translate this concept to the community health? What is value-based community health? Although there is no fully established definition, if we want to introduce the Porterian concept of value in community health, we must take into account the three drivers that define the essence of value: the effectiveness of the programs, the perception that citizens have of them, and the cost attributable to these actions. The Institute for Healthcare Improvement developed a methodology that allows the evaluation of the value of clinical programs. The Triple Aim initiative is about assessing the balance of the healthcare programs between health outcomes in population terms, patient experience in terms of degree of involvement and efficiency in terms of cost reduction per capita. Thus, the triple aim should be the inspiration for the development of community health models in primary care. In most healthcare settings today, no one is accountable for all three dimensions of the triple aim: for the health of the communities, for the health of the school systems, and for the health of all the patients. Systems need to address all three of the triple aim dimensions at the same time. This is the key, at the same time. The Institute for Healthcare Improvement developed a methodology, because the triple aim entails ambitious improvement at all levels of the system, the Institute for Healthcare Improvement advocates a systematic approach to change. Based on four phases of a pilot testing with over 100 organizations around the world, IHI recommends a change process that includes identification of target populations, definition of system aims and measures, development of a portfolio of project work that is sufficiently strong to move system level results, and rapid testing and scale up that is adapted to local needs and conditions. IHI believes that to do this work effectively, it's important to harness a range of community determinants of health, empower individuals and families, substantially broaden the role of impact and impact of primary care and other community-based services, assure a seamless journey through the whole system of care throughout a person's life. But when we talk about the determinants of health, it appears the paradox. Michael Marmot states that if determinants of health are mostly social, the solution must be also social. It must be admitted that the capacity that health services have to modify the influence of the environment, housing, education, transport, or work on population health is limited. Not only that, but by promoting activities and interventions for which neither organizations nor health professionals are especially competent, could distort healthcare priorities, which has often contributed to the medicalization of life, according to Iona Heath. Doctors are colluding, says Heath, with politicians and journalists in the systematic exaggeration of the power of preventive medicine, with the dangerous and misleading suggestion that more can be done to promote health through reorganizing the health service than through reforming society. Despite all the emphasis on diet and exercise, says Iona Heath, the most powerful determinant of health remain wealth and happiness. An exercise and an unrealistic commitment to prevention of sickness could destroy our capacity to care for those who are already sick. The primary solution, conclude Heath, should not be medications, but a genuine commitment to fairness and justice in a human society. Well, trying to manage the determinants of health paradox after the hit wars, we try to harness a range of them. As the Institute for Health Care Improvement said, my proposal is to go to a vision for population health, a document published recently by David Buck and colleagues at King's Fund. According to it, population health needs to be rooted in what drives our health and what can be improved and maintained over time. Given this, And given the evidence, it should be no surprise that the four King's Fund pillars see as crucial to this are the wider determinants of health, the health behaviors and lifestyles, and integrated health and care systems, and the places and community people live in and with. Thus, a comprehensive approach to population health must be able to work across all four pillars, looking for common spaces among them. Well, this is an intention to overcome the determinants of health paradox that he said, trying to harness the part of determinants of health that could work together with the other pillars. A proposal based on the quantitative estimation of the influence of the most decisive social determinants of health, such as housing, environment, transport, education or work, and the health system, has led King's Fund to classify, according to the degree of available evidence, the impact on health, the speed in obtaining it, and the contribution to the reduction of inequities of the intervention in each of these social determinants of health. See how, for example, best start in life and healthy school are one of the most intensely beneficial and best contrast influences on health and, moreover, contributes very significantly to the reduction of the most unfair inequalities. Although, as is understandable, this influence needs time to materialize. In contrast, interventions that improve transport have a rapid effect on health, but do not contribute so much to the reduction of inequities. Community health is an intervention model that aims to improve the health of a defined community that should operate from primary care, community care, and public health services to adjust their actions to the social reality of each territory. If we analyze the reality of community health in Galician, or even Spanish primary care system, there is a tremendous variability, with professionals who, drowned by the pressure of demand, continue to act exclusively in a reactive manner, and, on the other extreme, with others that undertake community actions without any scientific basis. In general, it is observed that, more or less correctly, there are primary healthcare teams that are very involved in the affairs of their communities and others that are not at all. The conclusion is that, despite of having a primary care with universal access and close proximity, there is neither a homogeneous discourse nor a clear community health project. Assessing evidence is not been easy. In the preventive medicine monographic, Interventions in Primary Care in Health Promotion and Disease Prevention, Edurne Zabaleta and colleagues conclude, solid evidence exists of the effectiveness of strategies for health promotion and for the prevention of various chronic diseases, and the primary health care system is an ideal setting to carry out these interventions. Nonetheless, a major gap remains between knowledge and practice. And the others add, successful implementation of health promotion and disease prevention intervention requires that they be designed with an awareness of the barriers that exist in the setting where they will be carried out. The skills of the professional responsible for the intervention and the other characteristics such health status, needs, values, and preferences of the citizens. It is essential to gain a deep understanding of the context, which also influences the effectiveness of the intervention. In this monographic, there are several reviews that assess that effectiveness in the adult population of interventions by primary care professionals to promote mental health and healthy lifestyle and the conclusions are few studies and poor evidence, or even lack of it. What do Cochrane reviews say? According to Cochrane reviews, primary healthcare models should promote the following 8 programs because there is some evidence supporting them. Information strategies on childhood vaccination in low adherence groups. Programs for the promotion of maternal and neonatal health primarily aim for the at-risk groups. Intervention to reduce the risk of sexual transmission of AIDS among the men who have sex with men. Programs to reduce tobacco use among young people, weak evidence. The prevention of diabetes too. Studies are all in developing countries and the evidence is low. Community interventions aim at increasing influenza vaccination among those over 59. Fall prevention programs in older people living at home, with a particular emphasis on physical exercise. Activities aim at people with multiple chronic conditions to prevent depression and improve difficulties in its functionality. Finding evidence in community health programs has been difficult. Firstly, because of the confusional impact of health determinants, but secondly, due to the difficulties in standardizing programs and adjusting the variables that define the different communities. What about the Triple Aim as a model for a value-based community health? Triple Aim is an inspiring source in the value-based healthcare. But it is not a specific community health model. Looking for it, I found out that there is not an universal model of community health in primary care. But after my review, I would like to cite 4 models that could help. The Medical Research Council framework, described by Campbell and Creech in 2007 and 2008, with 5 classical sequential phases: definition, construction of the model, development of a pilot study, assessment of the pilot, and long-term implementation. There is clearly not a triple aim model, since it does not guarantee by itself neither the experience of the citizens nor the studies of cost effectiveness. Sorry, I can't read without light. Could you open the light, please? Difficulties for the lecturers. Thank you very much. The second community health model that I would like to explain is the community engagement that NICE, the British agency, proposed in 2016 and is described in its webpage. This guideline covers community engagement approaches to reduce health inequalities, ensure health and well-being initiatives are effective, and help local authorities and health bodies meet their statutory obligations. This model is a double aim: effectiveness plus people engagement. The third is the hierarchy of prevention interventions, described by Simon and Anne Capewell in 2017. This is a proposal at 2 levels, one working in downstream preventive activities, targeting individuals and working and using behavioral methods. It could permit achieve health impacts in small populations. Second, working upstream at the level of policies, sweet, trans fat, smoking, and alcohol taxes. This model could be a weak triple aim. Weak because effective and people engagement, it could be demonstrated, but the cost reduction has a long-term perspective. The fourth, that for me is the most, that fits most at our reality, is the asset-based approach described by Rafa Coffino in 2016 and colleagues. This model is proposed by the Community Health Alliance, Alianza de Salud Comunitaria, which will be presented in one of the workshops in this conference. This is a triple aim model because it tries to revitalize health promotion and community health interventions, combining work with multiple partnerships, positive health, community engagement, equity, and orientation of health determinants. To finish, an integrated and care systems and communities. Proposed by Buck and Wenzel, there is a model that proposes four approaches in a continuous evolution that goes from communities to service focus. In the upright quadrant, we can see the first approach named community development. It is an approach that strengthens communities so that they can improve their own health. For instance, healthy lifestyle programs. Downright, the second approach is called community commissioning, in which communities have greater control over the commissioning of services they receive, for instance, self-care programs. Down left, the third approach is named community and service design, an approach that involves communities directly in the choice and design of services. Design thinking, elaborate in a shared way between patients and professionals in chronic care programs, would be an example of it. The fourth approach, up left, it's called communities in pathways of care. Expanding the scope of services, the health system is able to provide to include social as well as medical models of care. For instance, learning to evolve a clinical guideline into a care delivery value chain, or the promotion of several projects of integrated care, such personal health budget project in personal health budget project in England, a project that finances directly people who has been engaged in an integrated and personalized care plan. In conclusion, to promote the value of community health, the primary care system needs to develop its own model that would be a triple aim based, promoting effective activities, involving citizens in the objective of the programs, and performing cost effectiveness studies. In this new framework, the need for more training of primary care professionals should be foreseen, in addition to the coordination of strategies with the other services that also act in the community, such as social services, public health, or mental health. Thank you very much.